Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM AppConnect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate some new capability that has been added for integration with IBM Event Streams using the Kafka nodes. I'll be demonstrating the new KafkaRead node and using a Kafka policy. So let's get started. If I open up IBM Cloud, I have here IBM Event Streams. I don't have any topics created at the moment. I'm going to create a topic. And I'm going to call it Bond Films. And I am now going to publish some messages to that topic using a Kafka producer node. Now, in order to connect to IBM Event Streams, I need to pass some credentials. So in order to do that, I need to go to the Credentials tab, open up Credentials, and I need to use these credentials when I send messages to IBM Event Streams. So let's do that. In my toolkit, I can create a local integration server and start it. I'm just using the default ports. And after it's started, it gives me a link to the console log. So I can see that it's started. And if I open up the work directory, the work directory is called test server underneath independent resources. And underneath the override subfolder, there is a serverconf YAML. If I open that up, it's defined these default ports for me. So I am going to add some lines in here for the credentials. Paste in the credentials here. So I'm going to use these credentials to connect to IBM Event Streams. Now, the identifier being used is called Event Streams. Kafka here is the type of the server credentials, and that's the name of my credential. And that name will be referenced in my policy. So I have a flow here which uses a Kafka producer node that's going to publish messages to the Bond Films topic that I just created in IBM Event Streams. I'm going to read some lines from a file called Bond Films, and it's going to read it line by line. And each line will be written as a message to the topic. So this node, Kafka producer node, is referencing a policy called Event Streams Policy that is inside this policy project called Kafka Event Streams Policy Project. And if I open up that policy, we can see that it's using the security identifier that I just mentioned. And this server address matches the same one that is specified in the service credentials. Okay, this one here. First of all, I need to restart my server because I updated serverconf YAML. So I'm going to stop the server and then start it. So when it restarts, the new additions that I added to serverconf YAML will take effect. So start is just starting now. So that started. So I can see it started. And now let's deploy the policy project first. So that has deployed the policy project. And now let's deploy this message flow. So that's deployed. And it reads from a file. So let's create that file. The file is called bondforms.txt, so I've got a copy of it. These are the lines in the file. If I copy this file, that will cause the flow to read that file and publish the messages to the topic. So if I now click on the view button, I can see that it has read the messages from the lines from the file and written it to the topic. So for the very first message, it's written the first film, Dr. No, to the Bond Films topic. Okay, so it's done that. Let's stop that. Now I can check the topic has the messages in it. So I can use a flow which uses the Kafka consumer node, and this consumer flow is reading the Bond Films topic. It's using the same policy, which has the details for the IBM Event Streams details. and it's going to write it to a file called consumed messages from event streams topic. So if I run that, I can see that it's been deployed. And if I click on view, I can see that it has read the messages from the topic. And if I go to the file system, I can see it's created this file here. If I cat this file, then I can see that it has consumed the messages from the topic and written it to the file. Okay, so we've published messages to the topic and we've consumed messages from the topic using the existing nodes. So new in AppConnect Enterprise version 11 Fixed Pack 7, we've added a KafkaRead node. Now the KafkaRead node can be used to read a message from a particular offset in the topic. So I'm going to read a message from the topic. So I have configured the flow to use the same policy as before. So if I click on record now, so that is deployed. Here you go, there it is there, deployed to the test server. I have a compute node here, which reads values from the message and sets them in the local environment. So I can dynamically set which offset, which topic, which partition to use. So if I put a message through, and let's say, for example, offset 5. If I click send, then I get back the message from offset 5 on Her Majesty's Secret Service. I can see where it's read the message from, so it's read it from offset 5 here, and I can also see the details that have been read. Now, in the KafkaRead node, we have an action that you can take when a message is not found. So by default, if no match is set, which means that if no message is found at the offset that you specify, it will be propagated to the no match terminal. Alternatively, you can specify earliest, in which case it will retrieve the earliest message from the topic, which has not expired. And if you specify latest, then the flow will block and will wait until the next message is published to the topic and it will read that message. So let's leave it at no match and specify an offset which doesn't exist. So for example, let's specify offset 50, for example, and click send there. And when that happens, when the message is not found, the input message tree is propagated to the no match terminal. So here I can see the same message that I put into the flow is returned. So it's propagated to the no match terminal, and I can see that the input message has been propagated. If I specified earliest, then the earliest message is consumed. So if I change the KafkaRead node and set it to earliest, and save that, and deploy. Then if I put a message through, still specify offset 50, which doesn't exist, I click send, then this time it has received a message, which is the very first message in the topic. So the very first film was Dr. No. And if we look at the local environment after the KafkaRead, we can see that we specified offset 50, but actually it's read the message from offset 0, which is the earliest message in the topic that it could read. And I can see that it has Dr. No, year 1962, actor Sean Connery. Okay, so let me stop that flow. Now you can also merge the input tree and the data that's read by the KafkaRead node from the topic. So by default, the data that's read from the topic will overwrite the input message tree and I'll be written to the output tree. I have another flow here which demonstrates merge. So if I open up this, so in this flow, I'm actually using a mapper node just to show that you can map values to local environment. So here we have the original input message has parent element called original, but has a child element called film number and film. And I'm setting from the film number into the offset. And in the flow, in the Kafka read node, in this particular flow, in the result tab, I've specified that I want to read the message from the topic, from film, and I want to place it in the output message tree under original slash film. And that will mean that in this case, the parts of the input message will be retained. So if we go ahead and do that, I'll deploy this flow and put a message through. So I'll choose a Bond film. So I've got film offset 2 I'm going to specify here. Click send. Then we can see that the data from the original message has been retained. So it's film number 2. And the input message has been augmented with data from the topic and been placed in the output message tree. So if I click on the envelope after the Kafka read node, we can see that offset 2, we've received film Goldfinger 1964, Sean Connery. Now then, if I specify an invalid user ID, for example, in the serverconf YAML, so if I delete this and put in an invalid value, and after changing the serverconf YAML, if I stop and start the server, then we'll see that a failure will occur when the Kafka read tries to process a message, and we'll be informed that an authentication failure occurred. So let's do that. If I open up Kafka read, if I put in a message, so let's put message 5 again, click send. And this time you can see it's been propagated to the failure terminal. And in the failure terminal, you will see that there was an authentication failure. So authenticated failed due to invalid credentials. So I've demonstrated using the Kafka read node, which is now available in AppConnect Enterprise version 11 Fixed Pack 7. I've used a new Kafka policy type and referenced that policy from the node. And I also started the integration server from the toolkit. And I have a separate video which goes into more details on how you can start an integration server from the toolkit.